And now we're going to talk about the module of the week. So let's bring in Martin Anderson Klutz, Senior Solutions Engineer at Aqua, maintainer of a large number of Drupal modules of his own. Martin, what do you have for us this week?
So this week we're going to be talking about a module called Event Condition Action, also known as ECA, which provides a powerful, versatile, and user-friendly rules engine. It was created in July of 2021 and currently has two versions available, a 1.06 release and a 1.10 Alpha 2 release. Both support Drupal 9 and 10. And both were released November 18th, so quite recently. And I think that's one thing anybody who's interested will find about ECA is that it's very actively maintained. There's actually a team of developers who all seem to be quite involved, have biweekly meetings in Slack. Currently only used by 302 sites, but as I say, it seems like the issue queue moves pretty fast on that module. The team of maintainers is led by Jürgen Haas, who's a longtime Drupal contributor and himself a maintainer of quite a variety of modules. I think for anybody who has used, let's say, the rule module, either in Drupal 9 or in earlier versions of Drupal, one of the big things that sets ECA apart is its use of business process modeling notation, or BPMN. You can either use that sort of built directly into the website as sort of a visual workflow editor, or you can also use like desktop software. There's a application called Camunda that they mentioned on the actual ECA project page. So a variety of different ways to sort of integrate that with, I would say, you know, very robust, you know, kind of business workflow software. So really allows a site to develop a very complex set of rules, but in a way that, you know, because it's visually built, can be easier to work with sort of other business stakeholders. And the other thing that I think is really interesting about ECA is there's also a pretty rich ecosystem of modules in terms of integrations with a variety of other sort of Drupal contrib modules. So maybe to kind of open this up to the group, you know, let's talk a little bit about cases where you've needed to implement complex rules in Drupal, and maybe in particular cases where that kind of a visual approach to building out the rules would have been helpful.
Can I ask a question before we dive into that question? And this might be like an old time Drupal-y question, so I apologize. Is this like a rules replacement, like a rules module replacement, or is it an addition to? Like, how does this kind of fit in?
I would say it's an alternative to. So the rules module is available for Drupal, you know, 9. I'm not sure if it's ready for 10 yet, but I think last time I checked, it was still in an alpha state. And so ECA was really developed, I think, to provide a rich set of rules that's a little bit more stable, and then also has this sort of, you know, BPMN notation feature to, you know, add a new layer of capability there.
I have to say, I'm really excited about this module. Not so much because I would use it on every single site, right? Now that I'm a much more proficient coder or developer, you know, I probably would do a lot of the stuff that you can do with a module like this in a custom module, right? But I think there's two huge advantages. One is I think that the rules module, especially in Drupal 7 and before, was a critical part of the Drupal training pipeline of like up-leveling kind of junior developers or site builders into more of the developer space, because rules gave you a way to really like, how do you think about a problem? How do you think about, you know, if this, then that, and how do you think through what that workflow looks like, but gives them a kind of point and click interface. It also gives the websites kind of the ability to, on the other side, it gives the websites the ability to grow. So another thing that Drupal 7 did great is if you were a really small business just starting out, you didn't have a huge budget, you could hire a site builder and get a lot of this stuff into rules. And then as the business grows, maybe a lot of those rules gets replaced with a custom module once you get bigger. But there's a big base of, you know, simpler Drupal sites that get this that can grow organically from very simple to very complex. And without that kind of point and click adventure portion of it, it's hard to have both the site builder, you know, the complex site builder role, as well as have the simpler site with slightly more complex functionality. So I'm, like I said, there might not be, now that I am more familiar with coding, I might not use this on every project. It might be useful for those types of rules, kind of like web form, where you want the, and you have an end user with a slightly technical person, you want them to be able to tweak things, you know, maybe change thresholds or things like that. It might be great for that situation too, because then you don't have to build out that whole interface. You don't have to build out all the configuration for it. So I'm really excited to start looking at this again. I think it's really been one of those things that the Drupal community, it really stood out. Rules really stood out in the Drupal community and has been missing for a long time.
I can say that rules really helped me a lot. I do a lot of development work for tabletop role-playing games, and I built a website called Bits and Mortar, where, like, if you buy the physical book, the store that sold it to you can send you the PDF. And I used rules a lot to, like, do, like, download counts, to provide to publishers, to lock down downloads. Like, after 5 downloads, they were done. I'm not the engineer that everybody else on the call is. And so I was able to, like, put my logic in a point and click adventure sort of way, like you said, Nick. And so this particular module, like giving that capability to Drupal 9 and Drupal 10, is going to be awesome. I'm probably going to explore it too, because Bits and Mortar is getting a little bit long in the tooth and could use an update.
Yeah, I think I would echo some of the other comments here and just say that, you know, I haven't personally had a chance to play around with this a lot, but I'm excited for the opportunity when I eventually have the right project.
Thank you, Martin. I would like to mention too that this is probably the most requested module of the week. I think it's been it was requested even before you started taking over the correspondence piece of this, but it's been requested a few times and since you started. So on that note, if somebody does have a suggestion, feel free to ping us in the Talking Drupal channel or the Drupal Slack, and Martin will take a look and get it on the schedule, I think. So thank you, Martin, and on to our primary topic.